Hello and welcome to my first video. This is Bosco. So today I replace my FreeNAS Supermicro server into a new FreeNAS, a new Supermicro. My current FreeNAS Supermicro server is an Intel based machine. I use two E5620 4 cores and 8 threads, so total this machine have 16 logical CPUs. I use a HP RAID card in IT mode and some network cards for 10 gigabit. This machine only has PCI 2.0, so I think with this machine, with this new Supermicro, it is a Supermicro X90 Li N4F Plus. It has only PCI E3.0, and it's with newer Intel based CPUs, and today it become E5-2620 running at 2 GHz and turbo boost at 2.5, I don't know, and it's a 6 core CPU, and I use two of them for this machine. I start to put the new CPUs into the new server. This 2620 E5. Here it is, 6 core and 12 threads. So let's start. So now we move the heat sinks. Put the new CPUs inside. So, okay. So, what comes in? Good. Twenty 2 GHz. So is that the right side here? So I think so, that's better. Yes. That's good. Okay. That's number one. I think that's enough. And heatsink number 2. So, that's fine. Okay, so that looks good. I shut down my current FreeNAS server and put this RAM into the new machine.
And shutting down.
And it's powering off. What have we here? This is an 8 GB ECC memory stick. So, what is fused? Don't know. So, for the best performance, I use the same RAM in the same bank.
So, the first bank. What is the first?
So, it starts here, that's the first. The first bank.
So, I'll put some SSC memory into here.
Okay,
so second, it's A1, A2, A3,
okay,
so it's completely different.
Okay, I think now it's time to check. Powering on. Okay. Oh yeah, it works. It works. So the system is hanging now. I don't know why. So I remove this older RAM modules, and
so let's see if it works. So V7, it stops here.
Okay. So, the system initialization B7 says your memory have a problem. So, I remove all memory sticks and check it stick for stick. So, power off.
So, I remove bank B. And what is this?
F. So, and check it again. I have now installed only one module per CPU. So, maybe have a look. Yes! Ha! It works. Okay, 78, yes, okay. Yes. So the new system is working now with 64 gig ECC memory. I'm not using these old modules from my old FreeNAS server. I think maybe it's have a problem with that. So I only use 64 gig ECC memory. Now I put this PCI cards, two dual 10 gig cards, and this host bus adapter card into the new machine. I start with this HP card. It's an HP H220, and it's I'm using firmware from HP version 15, and it's run in IT mode. So that slot is for CPU 2. That's CPU 2, 2, 2, and 1, 1, 1. So that is the network 10 gig dual network card. I use it for the hypervisors, for Proxmox, for backup LAN to my FreeNAS backup server. It's pretty good. I take it from eBay. It works right. This is a Chessio. What have we here? Maybe have a look. CC2N320E. Okay. I think that is a place for the second host bus adapter in IT mode. It's the same HP. So on the second card I use it with fiber.
LC connectors.
First host bus adapter, this is the second host bus adapter, and two dual 10 gig network cards. Pretty nice. So now we can test it if it works. So the cards are working now. The system is rebooting automatically for configuration. The new cards for the system controller. So that is the old Supermicro FreeNAS server. What have we here? What is this? This is an X8 DTE LN4F. Okay, that's an older type, but it runs very well. So now it's time to remove the ZUS cable from this machine. ZUS mini cable. So I remove this cable from the back plane and put it into the new
big plane.
So that is the first cable. So I put all the mini-ZES cables into the back plane. All ZES cables are connected to the SRTR ports. Now I put the hard drives inside here. So starting with the system disk. 120 gig for system and 480 gigabytes Kingston SSD for caching the ZFF file system. I use a standard adapter for 2.5 disks. So that is the system. System SSD. Not bad. I use 4 terabyte Western Digital Red hard drives. So this is the last disk. So 24 terabytes. Now it's checking all the disks. I hope it works. That looks good. Okay. It looks like it's booting from the pool disks. That's not working. So I go into the BIOS. So, FreeBSD is booting up, complete. So now I can check the network cards. Connected the network cards, and I see E5-2620, running at 2 GHz, 24 cores, 64 gigabyte memory. That works. My pool is now encrypted. I start to decrypt it. Now it begins the IIS instructions to encrypt. So that is the cache SSD. So that works. That's my coolant. Be nice. That's my new FreeNAS server. I'm done. The new machine is working now perfectly. I tested all the network cards. So, my new FreeNAS server, it's working now. Pretty nice. That's an awesome machine. Very powerful machine, and I think I have a lot of fun with it. Thank you for watching, and yeah, see you. Bye.